breaking away. We are just a couple miles east of the LAX airport, just off the 405 and the 105 at the beautiful SoFi Stadium in Inglewood.
Today, we start the new season with an AFC West division battle right out of the gate
between the Las Vegas Raiders
and the Los Angeles Chargers. Here's the kicker, Jason Myers, to get this one started. And we are underway in Southern California.
Well, this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. Start on the ground with Nick Chubb.
And not much doing there. Maybe a yard up to the 23.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stuck the run.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and nine. To throw is Wilson. He's going to wind up and air it out. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Las Vegas sending out their punter now. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. And he will score. Touchdown. A great effort there with his first career NFL touchdown.
And the Chargers get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon.
Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff.
And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
From the 36, Wilson. This is intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six on a Charger TD. The extra point now coming from Myers. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They find themselves in a good-sized hole here, and a good-sized hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now it's Wilson. That's caught by his tight end, Dawson Knox. A gain of eight there on the play. And they'll be faced with a third and inches.
Wilson. And that nearly intercepted. Well, for a guy known for his hands defensively, that's a ball he probably thinks he should. Instead, it's fourth down. Here's the Raiders punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. Only 29 yards on the punt there, definitely not his best. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. Chargers in good field position to start out. First and 10 at the 40. They'll run here with a rookie second round pick, Kenneth Walker. Now he's able to break through one tackle, but it slowed him down enough that he could only manage getting back to the line of scrimmage. This defense could use a few more plays like that right now.
It certainly could, but think about it from an offense's perspective right now. They've got a lead, but they don't want to throttle down too much and stall themselves. Still want to move at a nice pace.
12. Play action. It's Burrow. He's airing it out for Williams. This is caught inside the 15. A big play there for LA. 52 yards.
If there was one knock on Joe Burrow coming out of LSU, you know, it was arm strength.
Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And the Raiders pick it up. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
And he gets it to the 30 when it's all said and done. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. They'll go left side on the ground with Chubb. And he's got room. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. And with his speed, if he just finds the slightest crease, he can take it the distance like he did there.
How about the leverage up front? Offensive line out leveraging the defensive front to create that space, that crease that he was looking for. And once he hits open field, he's going to be very difficult to catch and corral.
On is the Raider kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Charger drive about to get going. They had the auspicious beginning to the season, a first drive turnover. Now they'll try again here, first and 10. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. Burrow throw. And he fires one that's intercepted.
Isaiah Simmons picking it off.
And the Raiders are going to take possession of the football. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Chubb will get the call running left. And
the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Wilson. It's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. You're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
Going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. That kick, by the way, Charles, a career long.
Well, we did watch him in pregame, and he hit from this distance, so not a surprise. But there still is something exciting about it, carrying it over from practice in pregame to actually doing it in live action.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
On two.
The Charger drive about to get going. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. Trayvon Walker makes the tackle.
They suspected it was a power play up the middle coming out. And boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
Throwing on second and eight. Burrow. He'll get this to his tight end. That's Pat Freiermuth. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 49-yard line. Now a first carry for their fullback. Kenny Clark, the big D tackle there to make the stop.
12-12-12.
Off the play fake. Here's Burrow. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. He'll get it inside the 20. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. So a good start to the campaign so far for them here in week one.
Yeah, all the things that you dreamed about in April and May and that you worked on in July and August, getting ready for this game, it's all coming together so far.
Extra point up and through by Myers. And that makes it a 21-10 game. After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Set to get this drive started. They'll look to make some inroads here, trailing 21-10 as they come up on a first and 10. Shreds him with a stiff arm, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 107 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in the season opener.
Boy, what would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
A right Waffles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
Picked off by Jerome Baker.
And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward. That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet, so they can work towards another couple of stops.
He's got a man complete, and he's in for a Charger touchdown. DJ Moore, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Chargers are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead.
Myers connects on the PAT, and the lead is up to 18 now. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
Well, still early in this one, Charles, but the last time this offense was out there, they threw their first interception of the ball game. So trying to avoid repeating that mistake here on this drive.
And to put a positive spin on it, at least it happened in the first half and not in a close game in the fourth quarter. But you're absolutely right, partner. One of the last things this offensive quarterback wants to witness again in this game.
Kind of an obvious question, Charles, but anything you try to avoid after your first pick, or you say it's one interception, we're still in the first half, I'm going to do the same thing?
I think you want to avoid playing scared, you know, and put it into the mind of the quarterback that you've lost confidence in him. Make sure you get some throws that he's going to be able to complete, make him feel good about himself, and continue to run your offense.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he will be out of bounds. A good yardage there, and he'll get a second to catch his breath as it leads us right into the two-minute warning.
Chubb on the counter. And he's going to take this down to about the 17. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three. And again, it's Chubb. They got two of the three they needed there. It leaves them with third and just a yard.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped it. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They go up the middle with Chubb. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Now a second timeout called for by the defense, as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
They go with Chubb on second down. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. They'll run with Chubb. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Nick Chubb, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend.
And the Raiders get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is down to 11 at 28-17. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
From his end zone, here comes Agnew.
A dangerous return man showing it here.
And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Charger drive about to get going. Already enjoying a two-score lead here late in the second quarter. Not a ton of time left. We'll see if they can work this at least into field goal range and try to get three to add on even more to their lead. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
And as a quarterback, you always want to exploit gaps in the defense, and he finds one here. Crossing route, working from right to left across the field. And once you get defenders going in the wrong direction, it is awfully hard for them to pivot back, and you end up getting the first down.
Flushed out right. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
Well, you know me, whether you need it or not, I'm going to give a little unsolicited advice. Just throw it downfield out of the pocket, only if you're absolutely sure. Otherwise, use your running ability and try and get those yards a safer way.
11 mighty.
And they go play action now. Burrow. And the Raiders have got him.
Here we go, here we go. 11 MT, 11 MT.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's going to go down again. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Charger drive about to get going. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
And they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
A give to the fullback on the dive. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Well, not a lot of flash and dash on that play. Second and two, and they hand it to the big man, and he ends up picking up a first down. A little bit of gray area there, though, but I think what they thought, hey, we hand it to him here. If we come back and don't get it, we still got another down to try and pick it up.
First down, here's Burrow. He finds his man complete. That's Gibbs. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it'll be second down. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Altogether, a pretty shaky start to the year for this defense as they defend another first and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting roughed backwards on this drive. Could throw another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Burrow once again here on second and 10. Open man, that's the tight end Freiermuth. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders' 29-yard line. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory as they're down to the 29-yard line. That one complete to Hill. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. Back-to-back nice gains. gains that one for 14 yards and another first. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Throw right side, complete to Williams. They'll get nothing out of that one. Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. Now it's Burrow. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. We're backed up here. Tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first.
11
on third down, Burrow. Oh, he's hit. He lost the football. Put it on the carpet. And the Raiders pick it up. To the end zone. It's a fumble return for six and a Raider touchdown. This defense, Charles, they needed some type of a spark to help get them back in this game. I think they just got their spark.
No doubt about it. You know, that's all they discussed. How can we get ourselves moving again? How can we get our team going? This definitely qualifies.
Here's Chubb to try to run it in. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Charger drive about to get going. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter, despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down. Sticking with Walker on second down. And only a couple there, up to about the 23-yard line. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Out of the gun, it's Burrow. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore.
Here we go.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. They go play action with Burrow. To his left. Now Burrow loses the football. When that ball popped free, we could hear it all the way up here. Those guys down on the field alerting everyone to the fumble. He's lucky that his offensive mates picked him up and jumped on it.
Yeah, and you have to think to yourself, and I'm sure they've been echoing it on the sideline and into the huddle. Guys, we have the lead. Just take care of the football. Don't make it easier for them to start to make a comeback.
Burrow's throw complete there to Moore. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The Chargers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 9. Burrow on play action. And that is incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
Burrow going for it on fourth. He's airing it out for Williams. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. And the Raiders are right back in this football game. A sizable seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people don't question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
202 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. They run again on first down. Chubb down to about the 32. But we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. On 3rd down, Wilson. Open man is Ayuk, complete. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 19. 11 yards for number 11.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
And he ran right through one tackle as he fights forward for a gain of 7. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. They run it again with Chubb. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. This is 3rd and 2. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the 5. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on 3rd. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on 1st and goal. And Chubb will try the middle here. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play as we have reached the 2-minute warning. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And they're knocking on the door. 2nd and goal now in a 1-score game. From the gun, it's a give to Chubb. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Nick Chubb with now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And the Raiders have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. Here's Chubb to try to run it in. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Charger drive about to get going. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team.
Well, he forces one there. It's a potential dagger as it's intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And the Raiders are going to take possession of the football. Some good games around the league here early in week one, and this one shaping up to be as good as any of them as we come up on a 1st and 10. Up the middle, it's Chubb. And he is going to lose yardage here. Now they had stopped him for a loss on the run anyway, so they'll decline that.
It's almost a good psychological advantage, isn't it? You created a penalty, and you still couldn't gain yards against us. No way we need to take that one.
A give. This is Chubb. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline to talk over what to do next.
Check, 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 check,
Nick Chubb. Oh, no, he lost the football. And picked up by the Chargers. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
I know you're looking at the scoreboard clock. We're getting near the end of this game. But they were what was really called four-minute offense. And that's practice, being taking care of the football, taking time off the clock, not giving them a chance to come back. The bottom line is, what did I say in the beginning? Taking care of the football. That didn't happen.
Didn't do it. A costly turnover. They'll run with Walker to begin the drive. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple to throw. Burrow. And that's caught by Williams. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 7 yards there and a first. And I believe the referee's been buzzed. Yeah, they want to take another look at this call, and it's certainly a big one here late in a tight game. So the folks in New York just going to wind up confirming what the official saw, as this play will stand as is. Now Burrow. That pass caught. It's Williams. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. On the give, this is their fullback. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
On second down, it's Gibbs, and he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts.
Here we go.
As the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. They'll run the option on third and short yardage. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. They're able to convert with a gain of 4. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And that's intercepted yet again. And that could be the backbreaker. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And the Raiders have just about sewn up this football game. Well, this is one heck of an individual performance we're witnessing. That is now his third interception. And keep in mind, folks, this isn't a safety or a cornerback. This is a linebacker.
Does this feel to you like he's having a flashback? Because a lot of these linebackers we see in the NFL, in high school, they were offensive stars. They touched the football all the time. It's like he said to himself, let's go back and put on the letter jacket and go get the football. How about this one? 3 interceptions thus far.
Well, this was not just the opener of a brand new season, but this was a division game here in week one. And to come through with a 1-0 start against a division opponent gives you a little.
You mean?
gets into possession of the Las Vegas Raiders. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Pretty much unreal, not just in terms of yardage, Charles, but also throwing the three touchdowns as well.
When you put the whole package together, I can make you a pretty good guarantee right now. He's going to see a few more people in the box every time he lines up.
Yeah, he rifles one that's intercepted. Desmond King picks it, and they will score. It's a pick six. Third down here for this defense as they look to hold on and force a field goal try. They give to Chubb out of the gun, and he'll be stopped well short. This defense already looking at a deficit on the scoreboard, but now what can they design here to disrupt this third down play? Throwing on third down, Tannehill going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared. Coming up here, this defense looking for a third down stop in the second quarter. Hand off comes to Chubb. And that one going nowhere. Try and throw for it with Wilson. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn. Second quarter, this defense looking for a big third down stop here. They're already down on the scoreboard, just trying to get the ball back to their offense. To throw is Tannehill. And he's going to have the hook up to Gage. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the... Second quarter, this defense looking for a big third down stop here. They're already down on the scoreboard, just trying to get the ball back to their offense. Tannehill. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. So two third down conversions up. And now this offense is... The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. So now, Charles, this drive maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Now they got to get to the line quickly. There's Wilson to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness. So the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. They go play action with Wilson. Wilson. toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with the incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops, and escape this drive.
And this is taken in at the five. Touchdown, Raiders! This offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. The third quarter starts with a run by Chubb. 40 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Throwing is Wilson. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Good clean play. No flags coming out of the pocket of the officials. Turns into an incompletion, and that should get them off the field with a three and out.
He's going to take another shot here. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Here's Nick Chubb as they try to fire up this run game. Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Second down, here's Chubb again. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. Now we get a stoppage because a member of the Raiders shaken up on that one. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Wilson. Going out wide, finds Chubb. And he is going to have the Raiders first down by about a yard. It's a gain of five on third and four.
I'm not sure that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw. Third down, sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Here's Chubb, back-to-back catches for him. And they're going to speed things up here. From the 39, Wilson. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Work to do here to avoid falling to 1-1, but this is first and 10 right now. Throwing again here, Wilson. That's complete to Mooney. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30. From the 30 on second down, Wilson. That's over the middle and caught by Ayuk. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals 19. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And this will be caught by Mooney. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. First and goal, they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Now a third and goal situation as this Arizona defense tries to stand tall once more. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. Touchdown. Brandon Ayuk. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. On first down, Wilson. Dancing. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Marching in for the sack, Matthew Judon.
Well, this certainly feels like complimentary football to me, partner, because the momentum from the team's touchdown drive looks like it's made its way over to the defense. They're working together in tandem now. Offense gets in the end zone. Defense with a big sack on the first play of the following drive.
And quickly, they get to the line. Now Wilson on first down. Pressure comes, and the Cardinals bring him down. brought down by multiple defenders, and it's a loss of 12.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down. That ball caught. Brandon Ayuk. And he is going to have a Raiders first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. No reason not to try it there. And they do indeed convert on fourth. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. They'll roll him out right. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. To Valdez-Scantling over the middle. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. And this is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. So it's a win here for the Arizona Cardinals. And we talk so much about the...